Hello, welcome to my daily guide with mdgolamide. Happy midweek to you all. Precious Jesus, our Savior and our Master, we've come again this day to learn at your feet. Guide us through your word in Jesus' name. Amen. We're taking Judges series 15 today, with the topic, the unfaithfulness of man, under the caption, God's strength in man, part 4. So we talked about Gideon's mistake. We said we cannot talk about his lessons without mentioning the mistake, the grievous mistake he made at the latter part of his life. So, those golds that were gathered were used to make a golden ephod. We described what an ephod is in the last edition. And because it was made of gold, they went pouring after it. The Israelites, they went pouring after it, just like the days of Moses. When Aaron made a golden calf, and the Israelites worshipped it. Although the scripture records that during Jerub-baal's lifetime, the land enjoyed peace for 40 years. Gideon was given that name when he destroyed the altar of Baal in his father's house. It means someone who is against Baal, Jerub-baal. Gideon had 70 legitimate sons because he had many wives and a concubine who bore him a son called Abimelech. And as usual, the Israelites went back to their sinful ways after the death of Gideon, not remembering the Lord their God again. But there is a striking point in that verse 35. The Israelites did not show kindness to the house of Gideon according to all the goodness Gideon did in his lifetime. That's chapter 8, verse 35. Such was not recorded that the household of Moses or Joshua were forgotten or not shown kindness. Could it be because of that effort which the scripture records became a snare to Gideon and his family? You see, as humans, we are bound to commit errors. The reason we need to constantly seek God's help to strengthen us in times of weakness, or even when we are in happy mood. In a mood of happiness, we need to constantly tell him to please correct us when we go wrong and pray for the grace to yield to his corrections when such scenarios occur. Shall we take our prayer points for today? Father, I receive the grace this day not to commit any error that will destroy my years of servitude to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Prayer point 2. Lord Jesus, if peradventure I had even committed such mistake which the accuser of brethren had recorded against me, let your mercy speak for me in the name of Jesus. As it is written, we overcame the dragon by the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, I erase such mistakes. In the name of Jesus, I erase such mistake by the precious blood of the Lamb. In the name of Jesus, and by the word of my testimony, in Jesus' name, amen. Prayer point 3. As Jesus is my living testimony, I cancel the consequences of such errors upon me, upon my household, upon my generations, now and in the future. In Jesus' name, I use the power in the blood of Jesus to raise a standard against any voice demanding that such consequences of my past errors be unleashed on me, be unleashed on my household, be unleashed on my generations to come. In the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus that speaks better things, silence such voices and speak mercy on my behalf. In Jesus' name, have we prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. God bless you all.